Good morning, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to another vlog. It is a beautiful Monday morning, and today we are on our way to Tom Hartley Cars. Now, if you guys don't know who Tom Hartley is, and you consider yourself petrol heads, forget about it, because these guys have actually inspired me for a very, very long time. I'll tell you more about the story when we get closer. We have the SV over there, we have the keys over here, and I think we should get in the car and start heading over. It's about 26 miles away. So, yeah, let's head on over to Tom Hartley Cars. Let's go.
I'm living the dream! Woohoo! Absolutely over the moon driving this car this morning. I can't describe to you how happy I feel right now. Just reflecting back on everything, alhamdulillah, I am living my dream! Wake up in the morning, jump in an SV and head over to Tom Hartley. Damn! So before we get to Tom Hartley Cars, I'll tell you why we're going. So as a young kid, Tom Hartley sell some of the most desirable cars on the planet. And they used to appear in a magazine called Top Marks when I was a little kid. Every time I'd visit the toilet, I would see the stock list. And so would my dad, and we'd always discuss what Tom Hartley had in stock. They've been in the game long, it's been passed on down generations, his son now manages some parts of the business. It kind of reminds me of the relationship I have with my dad and the way we've gone forward as well. It's all family run, and it is fantastic. Carl and I have connected in the past year, not through social media, etc. But I've known of these guys for a while, and you know, my cars have visited their place a few times. I'm yet to go myself, but that's what we're going to do now. I'm going to go visit Tom Hartley Cars. I'm going to see Carl. I'll tell you more about it when we get there. I'm going to enjoy my drive right now. You know, people would say to me, Aleem, why would you put mileage on the car? Why would you not want to sell it, seeing as it's making so much money over list? I mean, I could have, one second, let me work it out. Make like nearly over £200,000 in profit on this car. However, I just want to drive it. It is my generation's poster car. What the Lamborghini Countach was to your fathers, this Aventador Roadster SV is our generation's poster car. Every kid knows about this car. It belongs in every game. Phenomenal. This is my dream car. Period. And I want to drive it. Yeah, guys, my hat just flew off. I wonder how that happened.
That's correct.
Yeah, and can I take a mobile phone number?
Yeah, it's O. That's correct.
No, that's correct. And your surname?
It's Iqbal. I-Q-B-A-L.
I-Q?
B-A-L, Bravo Alpha Lima.
And a postcode, sir? That's printing off for you now, sir. You have 2 working days for that to be paid.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Where do I collect it?
Slip of paper out the glass window for me.
Oh, I got
okay,
it.
All the details are on there. You can either pay over the phone, sir, or online.
That's fantastic.
Thank you.
Thank you. Bye.
So not only have I lost my cap now, like I said, I don't know how that happened. I've also lost my card holder. Oh my god. Yeah, not only have I... but I also need to pay for this ticket because I never had the right cash. We're not far from Tom Hartley now, only 20 miles away. Who needs a hairdryer, eh, when you have a Lamborghini? These are the sort of roads you want to be hitting. I can't believe I lost my hat. We're nearly there anyway. So ladies and gentlemen, we are now here at Tom Hartley Cars, and behind me, before we go on to show you the rest of the stuff, I wanted to show you the new showroom that's on its way. So I remember speaking to Mr. Hartley Senior about this and seeing some images, some renderings of this online on his Twitter account, etc. And now I'm here and I can see it in person. It is a three-story showroom. Let's have a look. As you can see, a very, very extensive project. So it'll be three stories, because I was just speaking to Carl now, so I've just, you know, caught up with him. We had a little chat and he was just saying that he doesn't want to keep any of the cars outside anymore. So by having it three stories, you can put a lot of the stock in, showcase them in a beautiful, beautiful way, in a beautiful manner. It's just what the Hartley team need, seeing as their stock is always, you know, going through the roof. I'll show you some of their stock right now. They have some very, very cool cars here. And like I said, if you know about Tom Hartley Cars, you'll know one thing: that the gardens are always maintained to a different level. Let me show you some of the stock. Have a look at this. Oh, there you are. We have a 488. In a very reserved grey colour. It is a left-hand drive car with these Daytona-style seats. Personally, do not like those Daytona-style seats, but nevertheless, I've heard that these are fantastic, fantastic cars. The new engine won an award. We have this Novitec Aventador in satin black, looking very, very, very stealthy. Batman. Very, very nice. This, I believe, is a wrap. It's got the quilted interior, very dark tinted windows, so we can't really see that. Now, I want to show you, in fact, let's go on here. Nope, this is mine. So we'll ignore that. She's a baby, look at this. Flip it. Got light. I've literally chunks of my time, isn't it? So I'll show you, here we are. We have Lamborghinis. We have a Huracan Coupe in Rosso Mars. And one in Gelalo Orion, I believe. Pearlescent yellow. SLSs. Cars are constantly maintained. We have a lovely pair of SLRs there. Cars are always constantly maintained. Now this is a car that I was looking at and I was just like, Carl! Look at that silver Lamborghini Gallardo with a classic launch blue interior. Like, that reminds me of back in the days. Hey, GGT compared to the SLS. Still prefer the SLS. I mean, you can't really compare them. Totally different cars. You have a flying spur. You have a Cali T. So this is the turbocharged California, as opposed to the naturally aspirated V8 California. This is a 2011 California here, finished in silver. And the main difference, how I normally tell, is from the back, from the exhausts. You see the exhausts are
horizontal here. However, they are vertical here. So that's one way of telling, as well as the front. But yeah, that's how I normally tell, the quickest way. We have some Porsches for the Porsche Club people. Here is a lake. I'll show you what we're going to do on there later. So this is where Tom Hartley take their pictures now. So Carl was just telling me, his dad woke up one morning and said, listen Carl, we're building a lake, right? And we're going to take pictures of the cars on the lake. So Carl's obviously very baffled as to what his dad's talking about. And a few hours later, the diggers had arrived and they started digging up the lake. As you can see, there's a road going through the lake where you can take your cars on. And if you know Tom Hartley Cars, you know the images come out stunning, especially with weather like this. So we'll get the Lambos on it in a bit, get some pictures on it. Let's continue having a look around the stock because we have some very exciting stuff inside. We have this. Okay, I'm not very good with my classics, so do forgive me, but I believe this is a Jaguar E-Type. Am I right? Am I? Beautiful. Jack. It's a Jack. We have this Lamborghini. Okay, you know what? Coming to Tom Hartley Cars, you will actually learn what land it's the Jalpa. Oh yes, of course I have heard of that. I've never really seen one in person, so here it is. These are the old Lambos. We have an old Range Rover, that does bring back some memories. And my dad had a few of them when he was younger. We have the Bentley Bentayga. I don't know about these. I think they'll grow on me. But yeah, it really Bentley have really set the benchmark when it comes to luxury 4x4s. You know, looks wise, I'm not too sure. Reminds me, it does look quite similar to a Q7. Obviously, the front is stunning, big, bulky, but I don't know. Mixed reviews on that. That's some classic Ferraris. I believe this is a 575 Maranello. Was it the? This is a 575. I don't know whether I should call it a Maranello or not. Comment below if I've got this right. I'm educating myself along the way. We'll get Carl out in a bit, and he could probably give us a little bit more info. We have a Lamborghini Diablo. Ferraris, this Rosses 355, and now this is actually one of my all-time favorite Ferraris, the 355. My dad actually had one of these when I was younger, Ferrari 355 Berlinetta. I remember the lights when they go up, they just go boop, 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 boop. It's amazing, and it's got an amazing horn too. So yeah, that's some of their stock outside. I'm going to show you some more inside. In fact, we have an aerial here as well. Why does Carl buy such toys? He's a little kid. Piece of scaffolding with an engine. That's what it is, but a lot of fun. This Aston Martin classic being detailed by the team. This process. Very nice. Now let's show you inside the showroom. Oh, Carl. This, ladies and gentlemen, is Carl. I was just talking about you. I was like, I don't know. My knowledge on those classics are not very, very good.
You learn in time.
I just told him the lake story.
Oh yeah.
When your dad woke up and he just decided to build a lake.
Yeah.
A driveway on a lake. I'm gonna show you inside. I am deafened by the sound of this Aventador. Damn, it's loud! But what is this? Ladies and gentlemen, it's like being a kid in a candy shop. We have the beautiful, the legendary Ferrari F50. Wow, absolutely mint condition. This is what it must look like for someone taking delivery of a Ferrari F50
about 20 years ago. That's how old it is, 25 years ago. Wow. Look at that. Everyone having toys with this car. And then we have a Dino. And again, the condition of these cars are like as if they've just come out of the show. It's like we've gone back in time. Look at that. And we're not stopping there. It's a massive throwback. We look at the condition of these cars. This is a beautiful color. Wow. I'm speechless. Lost for words. Wow. The Rosso with a crema. This reminds me. Oh, it's just so Miami. It's just so Ferrari. Look at these. But we don't stop there. Ladies and gentlemen, the legendary Ferrari Enzo. Wow. In black. With red inserts. And extreme amounts of carbon fiber inside. Look. Wow, lost for words, lost. I can see how people can get carried away when they come over here. We have Carl's Bugatti Veyron as well. This is not for sale, this is Carl's personal car. It's the notorious Carlmobile. Wow, what I love about this Veyron is it's so, so classy with its color. So subtle, it's so, you know, it doesn't scream out, hey, look at me, I'm in a Bugatti. No, Carl's got this just right. And he really does enjoy the car. He loves driving it, he tells me. Carrera GT. I know a lot of you are fans. Car's notorious for taking away Paul Walker's life. Oh, here we are, finished in silver. You know what, it doesn't, you can't tell, like these cars came out in 2003/2004. Now, imagine that in 2000, it still doesn't look very dated, does it? It doesn't look dated at all. It does seem to still fit in with the cars in this day and age. Wow. And then we have a white Aventador Roadster here. Nice orange calipers, you don't see them often. And the suicidal white leathers, if you can, if you wear white jeans, or if you're gonna wear, the white interior looks fantastic, just not for me. I don't think I could look after that. And then we have an SV Diablo, finished in yellow. Wow. It's a generations game. So here we have some of the stock. Just wanted to show you this. This is a Diablo SV in right-hand drive. Not many of these in right. Obviously, you've got to remember that Lamborghini will produce a lot of left, so there's even less right-hand drive. We have it finished in yellow, as you can see. I'm just speaking to Carl about this now. This was a poster car. The Countach, the Diablo. Lamborghinis have always made fantastic poster cars, and this is no exception. Carl, how many miles on this one?
16,000, very many.
And it's yours for a mere
275,000.
Jeez, if you've got 270K lying around and you want a piece of history and you want your poster car, it's not a bad example. I think this looks fantastic. Lambos everywhere, look.
You want to get exactly where I am? See that shop there?
Yeah.
There, I'm going to get there.
Angles. Ladies and gents, angles. We've got the bulls in the water, cooling off. They're in the lake.
Face off.
It's a face off. We have the Novitec, which is extremely deafeningly loud, spitting out flames for jokes. And then we have a little cute little baby. My dad was actually asking about if we could get a wing for the Roadster. Wow, you know what?
What, you want a bigger wing for the SV?
No, not for the SV, for the red Roadster.
Oh yeah. I'll get you one.
Yeah?
I'll get you an Novatec one, same as that one.
How much?
$3,000.
Ooh, not bad. Damn. So these make fantastic images. Let's run across. Oh mate, it's a lot better from this angle. Because of the sun hitting the car, you're not working against it. Look at that.
But then I ran to the end of the start line,
yeah,
and there was all these like car spotters, and they made their own sort of road, you know, because they ran out of like barriers. And I was like, oh shit.
That's Carl talking about his adventures over the mod ball in his Bugatti. So if you were there, Carl apologizes for...
I'm sorry for your people I nearly killed. But I think you got some good footage though. Up close and personal with the VEYRON.
I definitely saw some of those videos on social media and the car was flying through the crowds. Luckily not taking anyone out. So here we are, we have Gary taking some pictures of the cars on the lake. It is definitely a sight. I could sit here all day and admire these cars. Look at it. You see, he does this every day. He's around these cars, yet when you have the passion for cars running through your blood, this will never get boring, especially with weather like this and a backdrop and a setting like this. I was just saying to him, I said, if you know Tom Hartley Cars, you'll know the one way to recognize them is well-maintained gardens.
Yes.
That is for sure. That has always been on point.
Yeah, we have a team every day, all day, every day.
It's gotta be
when
done.
When they stop, they need to start again.
I was just now going to pull out the Bugatti so we can get some pictures with the SV and the Bugatti. He's got Carl's on the VEYRON, and I've got Aleem on mine. So yeah, it should make a good picture. I was going to say to you, so if you guys may remember watching Tom Hartley Cars on Million Pound Motors on Channel 4, there's a documentary. But before we get on to onto the VEYRON, here's a startup of the Ferrari F50. Okay, not too loud. Not too loud at all. Get the cars off on the lake. I've got to show you something. I want to see if the camera can pick this up. Let's have a look. You can see the carbon fiber through the paintwork. No, I don't think the camera's going to pick that up, but I can see it. The paintwork's so thin on this car. And that's one way of knowing that, you know, it's a very original car, is because it's very difficult to replicate that paint job. Carbon fiber body, you can see the weave through the thin paint. This has got to be one of my favorites here. That was my childhood motor. So when I was a young kid, Tom Hartley Cars used to advertise on one of these magazines that my father and I used to read, and my dad always used to talk about Tom Hartley's stock. He was also a very big fan of Tom Hartley Cars, and it inspired us. They kind of helped us fall in love with cars. Just walking around here, I can see some articles. Right, and it just shows that, you know, this family-run business here, father and son team, and some, you know, long standing workers of this, the work ethic and the passion for cars can really be shown
throughout this showroom and surrounding areas. You can see everything. The car's been thoughtful. Look at that. It kind of reminds me of the relationship and the kind of way that we work our business. We run our business, the whole family-run feel. It's fantastic. It's like you're working from home. I love it. And I'm really, really proud to see them where they are now, the journey that they've been on. And yeah, who would have thought that, you know, 5, 6, 7, 8, 10 years down the line, I would be doing a vlog with Carl, who is the son. And yeah, we're just gonna park our cars next to each other and have a picture. A thoroughly enjoyable day with a very loud Aventador, very loud. It's Carl's baby. He absolutely loves it, look at it. Those lights are not faulty, before anyone says, it's just the camera's not being able to pick them up as well. So I've had an awesome time looking around the Hartley estate. Like I said, lots of childhood memories. I've seen it all through the magazines and all the years that I've been growing up, and it's been amazing to, you know, have a few hours this morning with Carl himself, and his Bugatti is amazing. That was like, inshallah, you know, that's goals, that is. He's got the Carl's plate on it. So yeah, who would have thought all these years later, you know, we would be sitting together and having a picture with the cars together. The lake, again, a fantastic feature. Great for the images. And the stock speaks for itself. You know, they've been in the game for years now, so it is a very mature setup and one that if you are thinking of buying a pre-owned vehicle, you know, and it really does matter. The reason why I buy cars from the dealership, why I enjoy buying cars from the dealership, is the aftercare. But once I buy the car and then I sell it on, and you know, that's when these kind of dealers come in, and the aftercare can sometimes be even better, in this case it is, than the dealerships. The service, the way the cars are maintained, constantly have people polishing, tidying up the cars. That's why we have Ferrari F50s here and Lamborghini Diablo SVs looking like as if they just rolled out the factory. That's the way they get maintained. And that's the way, you know, if you love cars and someone was to come and buy their dream car, that's the way it should be presented to them. And you know, they have great work ethic here. I've learned a lot from the couple hours that I've spent with Carl, a fantastic mindset. And yeah, it's been a really enjoyable day. I'll put some of the pictures that we've captured now at the end of this video. But if you've liked this video, make sure you give it a thumbs up. I'll drop the link to Tom Hartley Cars down below in the description. You can check out Carl's Instagram. I'll leave that in the description below as well. And yeah, hopefully we'll be seeing a lot more of what these guys have got to offer. So yeah, make sure you subscribe, share and like, and I'll see you soon for another vlog. Carl, anything you want to say? Nope. Man of a very few words. Take it easy, guys. God bless. Bye-bye.